So before going to the first session, we'll give Navriya time to take a break, please. You are still muted, Navriya. Make sure that your microphone is active.
Okay, ma'am. I'm sorry. Okay, I would like to pray again. Thank you.
Okay, so let's go to the first session of the seminar. This is your presentation time, Navriya. If you are ready, you can go ahead and share your screen.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. So, good morning, my friends, and good morning to my professor one is Ma'am Maida, and my reviewer is Ma'am Irma. Good morning. Today, I would like to present my proposal, but before that, I would like to share my screen. So can you see my PPT, ma'am? Oh, okay, thank you. So today, my thesis proposal is an analysis of idiomatic expressions used in movie soundtracks of film entitled Break It. So I would like to start chapter one. Introduction 1.1 Research background. Idioms are a combination of two or more words which create a completely different meaning from the original words. In English, idiomatic expressions plays a significant role in everyday life. Idiomatic expressions is used in various situations of conversation. People usually use it daily conversation, both formal and informal way. Therefore, it is important to learn idioms. Wait, can I see? Excuse me, ma'am. Can I see the
Go ahead, Mafria.
Therefore, it is important to learn idioms even by people who are not native speakers, because idioms are also used to beautify language or be a sign for certain social groups. And for simpler and more creative communication, so that communication will have an important value in relationship social. To know whether the types, meanings, and types of idioms that are dominantly used, researcher is interested in analyzing idioms through songs. The song used to analyze are soundtracks from a film entitled Worth It. Researcher uses songs because it is one of the most popular media by many people and helps in improving grammar and vocabulary. Based on the description above, the researcher formulates the research problems to be discussed as follows. What types of idiomatic expression are used in World 8 movie soundtracks? 2. What is the most dominant type of idiomatic expressions in World 8 movie soundtracks? And 3. What are the meaning of idiomatic expression used in World 8 movie soundtracks? And 1.3, research focus. The focus of this research is the idiomatic expressions in the lyric of soundtracks Work It, which consists of 26 songs. In this study, the researcher only focused on analyzing idiom expressions based on Palmer's theory, which has three types, namely partial verb, prepositional verb, and partial idiom, by analyzing 21 songs, to find out the most dominant idiomatic expressions and to describe the meaning idioms which are used in Work It movie soundtracks. The researcher only analyzing 21 songs because the other 5 songs are instrument. The titles are Let Me Move You, Baby Baby, Get On Your Feet, Onset, Do It Like This, Mess, Feeling It, Rent, Further Up, Na 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 Na, Motivation, Break My Heart, I Can Wait, Wow, Treat Myself, Ooh La La, Lost Cause, Thinking About You, Cool, Satisfied, I Am The Best, and Teach Me.
Neat.
And 1.4, research objectives. Based on the statements of the problems, the objectives of this research are 1. To find out types of idioms used in World 8 movie soundtracks. And 2. To find out the most dominant idiomatic expression used in World 8 movie soundtracks. 3. To describe the meaning of idiomatic expression which are used in World 8 movie soundtracks. And 4 and 1.5, research significance. Theoretically, the result of this study are related to the expressions and as evidence that the idiomatic expression is used in songs. And B, practically, for students, hope that this study helps may be used to help students who want to understand and master the idiomatic expressions. And first, this study may help English teachers as a reference or a topic idea to teach idiomatic expressions. And 3, for readers, hope that this study can be a reference to further readers who are interested in examining and learning idiom expression with different subjects or songs. And for 1.6, definition of keywords. The following are some of the terms that have a bearing in research. 1, analysis, a detailed examination of anything complex in order to understand its nature or to determine its essential features, a true study. 2, idiom, a group of words in a fixed order that have particular meaning that is different from the meanings of each word on its own. 3, soundtracks, refers to the collection of songs and musical arrangement played during a movie or television show. 4, song, a usually short piece of music with words that are sung or sang. Chapter 2, literature review. There are
I'm interrupting. Can you move ahead to the theories and the fun words?
Maafkan, ada saya enggak? Jelas.
Can you move ahead to theories, the core theories, and also the frameworks for the chapter 2? Do not read all of the slides.
Okay, ma'am. Chapter 2, literature review. There are idiomatic expression, types of idiomatic expression, and there are phrasal verb, prepositional verb, partial verb, soundtracks, and songs. And for the previous study that I as a reference of the researcher proposal, there are the first is from Rashada, idiomatic expressions, song found in Britney's song lyric 7 album American Idiot, and Fabila. Entitled a description of idiomatic expressions used in Miley Cyrus song lyric. And this is 2.6 framework. Finding the topic of research idiom expressions in song, finding theories of Palmer's partial verb, prepositional verb, partial idiom. Deciding soundtracks worth 8 movie, 21 songs. Identifying and classifying idioms in song based on Palmer's. And interpreting the results of identification and classification. And discovering the meaning of the classification result. Finding out the dominant type idiom expressions. Discussion and conclusion. Chapter 3, research method. Point one, kind of research and approach. The researcher used qualitative method research. The approach used in the research is descriptive content analysis because the researcher attempt to collect data identifying, classifying the idiomatic types of expression and discovering the idiomatic soundtracks in work 8 movie. 3.2, research setting and subject. The study was conducted in researcher place, then the researcher uses a laptop as a data collection media that can be accessed on the genius.com website. Then the data is copied and saved into a Word document. In this study, the subject used to analyze idiomatic expressions is the soundtracks of the work in movie, which contains 21 songs. And 3.3, role of researcher. In this research, the researcher as the instrument, as those who collect data, process data, and at the same time, analyze data. In addition, the researcher used the data as a key instrument. The data set is used to classify the data that is made in the form of a table, which aims to present the results that become the research objectives. And 3.4, techniques of data collection. One, researchers explore the data on the genius.com website. And two, researchers collect data by copying into a Word document and save the file name as 1 until S2021. Technique of data analysis. Researcher identifies and underlines sentences that have the characteristic of idiomatic expressions. Researcher classifies based on each type of idioms expressions according to Palmer's theory by using a table as follows. So this is my table. There are number, lyric, line, idiom, expression, types, phrasal verb, prepositional verb, partial idiom, contextual meaning. So I will put the lyric and the line, and then I that there I will underline the idiom expressions, and I will put based on the structure which is personal verb or preposition of verb and partial idiom, and after that I would like to I will make to find contextual meaning. 3.6, trustworthiness of data. Point one, credibility. In this study, the data taken is from a trusted source, namely the genius.com website. The data are songs from Rock 8 movie soundtracks, which will be analyzed using Palmer's theory to find results in accordance with the formulation of the research problem. 3.6.2, transferability. In this study, Palmer's theory and about idiomatic expressions can be used for further research to examine the subject of films or other songs and can help readers to recognize and understand idiom expressions. And 3.6.3, dependability. This data is taken from a trusted source on the genius.com website, and the research will be properly reported and using Palmer's theory so that the data will not change. And 3.6.4, confirmability. This research is not based on the author's opinions, but based on the data that can be confirmed on the genius.com website and Palmer's theory in his book entitled Semantics, Second Edition. So that's my proposal. I'm Novia, thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you very much, Novia, for the presentation. So this is the second session. It's time for Ibu Erma to review the proposal. So Ibu Erma, please.
Okay. Thank you for the chance given to me to review Novia's proposal on an analysis of idiomatic expressions used in movie soundtracks of a film in title Rock 8. So while I'm looking at your title, I found two similar words used there, movie and film. So it is a bit, it means that you repeated the same word the same meaning So I suggest you to simplify your proposal title, your title of section, by eliminating one of the words movie or film, because it's the same meaning. Okay, maybe you can make it into an analysis of idiomatic expressions used in, and then put the title of the film. Yeah, after that, movie soundtrack or film soundtrack, it's up to you.
Okay, ma'am.
What do you think? You know what I mean?
Sorry, ma'am. Your voice is a little bit not volume not I cannot clearly hear you. Listen
to you cannot catch my words or you don't understand my utterances.
I understand, but saya ngerti mem, tapi ada beberapa tadi yang hilang gitu mem suaranya karena saya kedengarannya kejauhan. Suara mem, maaf mem, suara memnya kurang keras.
Is it not loud enough, my voice?
No. I'm sorry, ma'am.
The signal in her place is not really good, Ibu.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Seems like that.
So I suggest you to erase or choose, whether the movie or the film, and you have to simplify your title, This is my suggestion. If you can accept it, it's okay. But if you have your own versions, that will be better. Okay? No. An analysis of idiomatic expressions used in and then put the title of the movie, yeah, work 8 soundtracks, or you may add movies soundtracks, yeah, use in cassette. So there will be no words of a film in title, yeah. Itu tidak ada, tidak usah. So it is simpler and understandable, I think. It can be touched by the reader. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. You go to the next part of your proposal, yeah? And on chapter 1 here, I found a very old reference from him, 1974. Almost the same old as mine. So I suggest you to find the newest or the latest reference to substitute this old one. Yeah. It should not be used anymore. Yeah. You have to find the latest references from some article. Yeah, discuss about the same or the similar things like as and yours. Yeah. Okay. Do you get it?
For chapter 1, comment.
Yeah, ya Allah, ya Rabbi. Berarti bukan suara saya ya yang bermasalah. You yang bermasalah tuh ya. The chip on your head. Ini ketuaan Mbak ya, Promkin ini 74 tidak boleh digunakan lagi, diganti yang baru ya. Chapter 1.
Oh ya, ma'am.
Oke, kamu tandai sendiri, oke? Okay? And then I found also some acronyms. Yeah, why do you use acronyms here, and whether it's valid or not? To be used as the reference here, yeah, like ETS Global. What ETS? What is ETS Global? Yeah, I don't know. And then another one is MED Magazine. Why do you put those as your references?
Actually, I found that references from the journal.
Journal?
Yes.
Yeah. So you have to put the journals, not these references, because you found this from a journal. So the reference you use is the journal, not this one. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Go to the worship here. Not the main reference, yeah, but the worship the second reference, yeah. So you use the first reference here when where you found these acronyms from the journal itself, okay? Yeah. And then, by the way, what is ETS here? I want to know. ETS Global, what does it mean? ETS itu apa? Kamu nulis jangan asal copy paste, ya, harus tahu. Tapi ya.
ETS Global is Educational Testing Service, ma'am.
Pardon?
Educational Testing Service.
Educational?
Yes, Educational Testing Service.
Not English Testing Service? What does E mean? E? E-nya apa?
Kalau E-nya Educational.
What about MED magazine? Medical?
Actually, I try. I did find the magazine. Magazine. itu seperti web gitu loh, ma'am. Like website, like website about news. So there are many, banyak, maksudnya banyak yang kayak misalnya khusus khusus materi kuliah, bukan materi sih, kayak lebih pengetahuan kayak berita gitu lah, ma'am, singkatnya. Berita tapi secara online.
Okay, have you put this on your references page?
Yes.
Yeah. With also the date and time ya, you access to the blog ya. Ada tanggal sama jamnya waktu akses ini blognya?
Just only tanggal aja, ma'am. Only date, not jamnya.
Okay, so try to be more complete, yeah. To add this reference on your. That's all. I don't know, yeah, whether this is valid or not to be used as the reference, yeah. Because a blog is similar to personal opinion, yeah.
Yeah.
Not a thing. You know what I mean?
Yes, ma'am.
So when I have some things on my mind and then I write something on my blog, that's my personal opinion about something, a certain topic. Yeah. So I suggest you, if it possible, you substitute this reference, yeah, by using expert's opinion on this thing, yeah, on idioms things. Kita ganti dengan pendapat ahli yang memang ahli idiom, yeah, not personal blog, kalau bisa, ya. Okay, that's my suggestion. Okay, now we go to page 2, yeah. Halaman 2, you lihat above the acronym of MEG here, you wrote repeated phrases here. Okay, sometimes we will find some sentences or expressions that are difficult to understand and understand. I don't know what you mean by difficult to understand and understand here. Is it different? Do they have different meanings, or is it different? Or mistype maybe?
Jadi sebenarnya, actually I want to put like mengartikan dan memahami gitu loh, memang maksudnya.
Oh, mengartikan dan memahami. Mengartikan, interpret.
Oh yes, yeah, yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So we go yeah to the next page of yours. Okay, you put an examples here. Cat, cold feet. Pak Tampung, mohon maaf kami mendahului. Ada Pak Tampung?
Iya, memang ada.
Ya. Oh, belum connect
ibu. Pagi Bapak.
Pagi.
Pagi Bapak. Mohon maaf mendahului ya Bapak.
Apa-apa, lanjut saja.
Oke, siap. Oke, okay, you put an example, get cold feet here. Where did you get this get cold feet from?
Get the get cold feet, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You're not free, yeah.
Excuse me, ma'am. What's the question there?
What is the question?
To get this idiom from?
Huh? Oh. Journal, ma'am.
So a journal, yeah. So I suggest you, because you are going to analyze idiom in the songs, soundtracks, yeah, of a Work It movie, you may do preliminary research first to search the idiom, yeah, on the lyric of the song or the soundtracks, and then take 2 or 3 of them, put on your background, yeah, as the example,
So you don't have to take it from somebody's journal here. Yeah. Have you done the preliminary research here by searching whether the soundtracks have two idioms or not? Ngerti nggak? Mohon maaf dari tadi anak ini.
Yes or no, Nafria? Have you done the preliminary research like I said before, just to scanning all of the songs?
Yeah.
Kalau
lirik on the soundtrack ya.
Kalau liriknya itu masih belum saya.
Nah, bisa proposal ya. Ini sudah proposal. Do you want to check the data first whether they have the idioms or not? Nanti kalau tidak ada idiomsnya, kamu usulin penelitian itu gimana lalu?
Because I think this is karena saya
rasa. You don't have to think, yeah. You have to make sure. So after these things, the examples, yeah, and take it from the soundtracks lyrics, yeah. From the soundtrack, you are going to analyze. Saran ya, ini saran sifatnya. Jadi diubah nanti contoh itu diambil dari lirik idiom yang ada pada lirik soundtrack filmnya. Oke? Okay? 2 atau 3, jangan 1 saja. And then I have not found the reason of you for analyzing this idiom in that movie or film. What is the reason or why are you interested in analyzing idioms in work it?
Why I interested this to analyze this because the movie is the musical drama, so mm-hmm. I think there are many music, ma'am, many songs. So so that make me too easy to find the music songs because not only 7 or 10 because but 26 or more than 10 songs. Mm-hmm. So I think I can find more idiomatic expression.
So you have to put what you explained to me on your background. Have you? Oh, yeah. That's good reason. Yeah, you have to retell a bit of the movie itself. Yeah. What is the movie about? It is a musical movie or musical or dramatic movie, I don't know. And then there are so many songs, blah, 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 having so many idiomatic expressions. And then you put your reasons on your background, yeah?
Okay. That's
also, yeah, for you to revise your proposal. Okay, and then we go to the focus of your research. I'm not sure on the organizations of the subtitles or sub-chapters, yeah? Whether what is it here? Focus of research, go first after the background or after the research problems or statements. Yeah, and I read the newest versions of Buku Pedoman.
Yes.
In the book, it explains that the focus of research is similar to the research problems. I don't know about it. Yeah. So. We still have to discuss this, yeah, maybe in a meeting for this meeting. But I suggest you to add to reorganize your subchapters into focus of research first, after that research problems. Urutannya dibalik ya.
Jadi research focus.
Yeah, yeah, 1.2 is focus of research, and then 1.3 is research problems. 1.4 is the objective of research.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. And then here on your focus here, you mentioned the theory of Palmer here without year. So at the year, yeah, or from where you got the theory? Tahunnya harus dicari. Setiap ada nama expert, ada tahun. Okay? Yeah. And then... there are 21 songs, yeah, you mentioned, yeah, okay, and on your research problem, yeah, on movie soundtrack, do you think you made something there? Movie soundtrack or movies soundtrack?
Research problem, ma'am.
With possessive pronoun or not? Yeah, you have to check your grammar. Okay, check grammar. Okay, there are three research problems you stated. First one is the type. The second one is the dominant type of the idiomatic expressions, and the third one is the meaning. What do you mean? Yeah. What do you mean by the meaning? Huh? What meaning are you going to analyze?
The meaning, maksudnya meaningnya itu apa gitu, Kak Mem? Yang yeah. Saya, oh ya, maksud saya itu meaningnya itu yang dari, kan saya menganalisis dulu, yeah. Apa saja, apa saja idiomatik yang saya dapatkan, and then I found the, I have to find the meaning of idiomatic expression that I found in, I find in the soundtrack lyric, ma'am.
The meaning. What I mean is the meaning. What kind of meaning are you going to analyze now?
On your table. On your table. What kind of meaning?
Your instrument table. The last chapter. You put it. On the last column.
Yes, ma'am. What does that mean?
What is it? What kind of meaning? Say it.
The meaning is, I mean, arti. Arti yang, bukan arti literally-nya ya, ma'am, tapi arti yang digunakan.
What is it? What is it? If it is not literal, what is it?
Contextual meaning.
Say it loud.
Contextual meaning.
Contextual meaning. Okay, you are going to analyze the contextual meaning of the idiomatic expressions found in the soundtracks, yeah, lyrics.
Yes, ma'am.
How will you analyze the contextual meaning? Caranya bagaimana menganalisis makna konteksnya, makna contextual atau situasionalnya?
I have to read one lyric. Satu lirik itu saya baca benar-benar, kemudian saya artikan. Jadi maka dari itu saya akan bisa tahu gitu, dan saya tentu pasti akan mencari juga referensi-referensi dari yang lain juga apa sebenarnya dan bagaimana juga.
Okay, you are discussing about reference. On meaning, have you put the meaning references on your property? Ada referensi yang kamu tulis tentang makna pada chapter 2?
Kalau untuk referensi meaningnya masih belum ada, ma'am.
Why? You mentioned that you will be helped. You will be assisted by references. So you have to put the references, yeah, to make you easier and also to make the readers easier in understanding on the steps you are going to do in relation to analyze the meaning here, contextual meaning. Yeah. Gimana caranya menganalisis referensinya belum ada di situ. Tambahkan referensinya begitu lomba. Ngerti nggak?
Iya,
memang. Cuma dekat di sini. Oke, so Here on page 10, I found a sentence of viewers, yeah, from the explanations above, it can be concluded that idioms are not easy to translate based on literally meaning of the words. Are you going to translate or are you going to discuss translation? Kamu akan membahas translation juga?
No.
Ya. Akan membahas translation?
Kalau misalnya secara kalau saya menganalisisnya, ya mem, akan saya translate gitu.
But what about your research here? Is it going to discuss about translation? Or just the meaning?
Harusnya sih meaning, mem. Cuman artinya saja. Apa arti?
Okay, the limitations, yeah. So you have to change the terms there so that the readers will not misunderstand. Yeah. Kata-katanya itu, kalau nulis itu diatur sedemikian rupa sehingga tidak menimbulkan pertanyaan pembaca, apalagi reviewer, you know. So, yes, translate ini dihindarkan, diganti dengan kata-kata yang biasa saja. Okay, karena translate ini nanti ranahnya mengacu kepada translation theory. Ya, in analyzing it, you, of course, because English is not our first language, you have to do understanding or interpreting. But you have to use English to put the result of your analysis, not in Indonesian kan, pada bahasa Indonesia. Okay.
Yeah.
Now we go to the types of idiom, idiomatic expressions or idiom expressions. Yeah, you have to be consistent in using the terms. Yeah, the same as you put on your title of proposals. Yeah, coba konsisten dalam menggunakan istilah. So you are going to use Palmer's theory. I don't know the year of Palmer's theory here. And there are three categories, or three types of the idiom. Phrasal verb and then prepositional verb. And the other one is semi-idiom, partial idiom. Okay, how can you differentiate each of the How can you differentiate between phrasal verb and prepositional verb and partial idiom?
In the phrasal verb, kalau misalnya phrasal verb itu ada biasanya menggunakan cuman up, out, down gitu, mem.
Pardon?
Jadi biasanya memang kalau phrasal verb itu biasanya identik hanya dengan itu saja. Yang ada yang up, down, in,
up,
gitu, mem.
Can up be classified into preposition?
That's phrasal verb, mem.
What is phrasal verb? Phrasal verb itu apa?
Phrasal verb is the combination of verbs plus adverbs.
Verb plus adverb.
Yes, ma'am.
So, misalkan di sini, it up, on end up, Up is. What part of it?
Up.
Up yang di situ, kelas katanya apa?
Adverbs, ma'am.
Adverb. Yes. Saya tanya sekarang. Up bisa nggak dimasukkan dalam kategori preposisi?
Harusnya bisa, ma'am.
Harusnya bisa. Terus bedainya antara phrasal verb dengan prepositional verb bagaimana? Contoh kasus di up tadi.
Kalau dari yang saya baca sebenarnya yang lebih sering digunakan itu kan kayak on, yang kayak on in gitu loh, mem. Sebenarnya itu masuk dalam phrasal verb juga.
Kalau ketemu up misalnya, Jadi kamu mengklasifikasikannya masuk ke present verb atau prepositional verb? Karena ini kita jadi adverb, ya enggak?
Ya.
Nah, stand up misalnya begitu contohnya, atau climb up, up, and then di sini eat up mungkin tidak ada ya dalam lirik lagu. End up itu ada. Gimana? Apakah itu present atau prepositional verb?
Present.
Nah, kalau dalam kasus up yang lain ini seperti climb up, itu preposisi atau present verb?
Apa tadi, Mem? From apa?
Climb, climb. Menjat.
Climb up. Hmm. Itu masuk present verb, Mem?
Are you sure?
Yes.
It's prepositional verb, up and down, you know, it direct you to a certain position. Itu menunjukkan posisi ya, up and down, atas, bawah. The preposition, not adverb, bukan adverb.
Iya sih, Mem. Sebenarnya saya juga kebingungan. Kalau boleh jujur, ya kebingungan sebenarnya yang...
Nah, so, you have to be checked on the explanations ya. You put on your proposal. It is not complete because it is still difficult to differentiate between the present verb and also prepositional verb. Read so many articles and theories and then add some explanations ya on your type of idioms ya.
Yes,
itu maksudnya ya. And put also the patterns if possible. Taruh polanya.
Yeah.
Verb plus adverb atau apa. Verb plus preposition and examples, ya. Yeah. And what is it here, the confront, what is it here, the question word, yeah, can be classified in adverb or preposition, yeah, for example. And then how will you put the word here, misalkan climb the ladder up or climb up the ladder. Boleh misalnya taruh di tengah, misalnya. Belum ada penjelasannya, ya. Apakah juga termasuk idiom atau bukan? You know what I mean?
Yes, ma'am.
Lack of theories. Teorinya kurang. So you have to add, ya. Selain tadi juga meaning, ya. No explanations on the meaning. Contextual meanings itu apa? You know, put the definition first and then you explain how you will find the contextual meaning of the idiomatic expressions here on the soundtrack lyrics. Jelas ya? How to revise your chapter 2. Itu saya suggestion saja, okay?
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, and then yeah, on the examples, you put on your type of idiomatic expressions here. If you take it from a certain source, you have to show ya the source here. Yes, ini contoh sendiri atau kamu ambil dari orang. Kalau ambil dari orang, jangan disembunyikan orang yang nulis ini, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. And then we go to the next, yeah. On your chapter 2, I also did not find about the movie. You just go to the soundtracks and songs. According to my opinion, it is very important why you choose this movie, not the other movie to be analyzed, yeah. About movie, why are you interested in this movie tadi? Tambahkan juga di chapter 2, okay? When was it really fun? And then the story, what is it about, yeah, etc. And especially soundtracknya ini diberitahukan juga, ya, yeah, the numbers of the soundtrack and then most of the soundtracks telling you about what kind of story. Ditanya tentang apa, begitu. So that the readers will know that you can find so many idiomatic expressions ya yeah, by looking at the lyrics of this song. Okay. And I suggest you also to put an opening statement on your first, second, and third chapter before go directly to the content of your chapter, ya. Tambahkan pembukaan. Kalimat pembuka pada chapter 1, jangan langsung 1.1 dikasih, ya, kula nuwun dulu, permisi dulu, saya mau membahas ini.
Oke,
okay,
ma'am.
Chapter 2 dan 3 juga, karena tidak ada.
Nah.
Oke. Okay. And then we go to your chapter, framework, ya. Yeah. Framework, a bit complicated when reading your framework. Ya. Yeah. Dan bookmu kok complicated sekali ya. Oke, okay, I suggest you to simplify it by go directly to the things that you are going to analyze. What are you going to analyze actually? Kamu tuh mau meneliti apa sih?
Meneliti.
Finding the topic of research. Ya, tulis aja topic researchmu itu apa di sini gitu. Tahu nggak? Huh? Bertele-tele nih. Ya, findingnya kita tulis aja kan sudah ketemu, dong. Sudah proposal kan sudah ketemu. Nah, topiknya. After that,
merah.
Ya, so you don't have to mention here the finding theories of Palmer's. If I ask you how did you find Palmer's theories, ya, gimana kamu menemukan teorinya Palmer's?
Searching, ma'am.
So it is not important, yeah. You just go mentioning the topics of your research. After that, what you are going to do with this topic, okay? Ngerti nggak?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. And then the previous studies or previous research here. What's the difference and the similarity between yours and theirs? Two references here or two practice studies. Mention the similarity and the difference.
Okay, ma'am. Iya, ma'am.
Kamu tak tanya dari tadi nggak ngerti loh, ya ampun.
Nggak jelas, ma'am.
Kalau nggak jelas tuh tanya. Maaf, Ibu. Bisa diulang. Itu loh. Kamu diam aja ditanya itu gimana.
Iya, ma'am.
Kamu tanya previous studies.
Iya. Yeah.
Ada kesamaan atau perbedaannya nggak dengan punya ini?
Persamaannya, untuk kalau persamaannya itu mereka sama-sama menganalisis lagu, mem, lirik lagu.
Lagunya sama juga.
Hah? Apa, mem?
Lagunya sama kah?
Beda. Tapi yang membedakannya mereka di sini pakai teorinya Makai, mem.
Kamu enggak di situ di tempatmu itu?
Ada yang di bawah.
Teorinya?
Teorinya saya pakai Palmer's teori, tapi saya tulisnya di bawah, mem, di.
Kalau mau nulis, jangan sepatah-sepatah ya. Kalau komennya memang di bawah, taruh bawah semua. Jangan satu kamu taruh komen yang tidak utuh. Kemudian yang kedua kamu taruh komen yang tidak utuh, baru kamu komen lagi. Make it into one paragraph, ya. To describe the similarities and differences between your research and the other research you use as references. Ngerti?
Jadi saya harus bikin satu aja gitu, Kak Mem?
Saya sarankan begitu, karena komen yang di bawah judul tidak sama dengan komen yang di akhir. You can discuss about the theory on the comments of viewers, yeah, after the first title and the second title. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Makanya kamu tidak sampaikan. Di situ mereka pakai makai semua, kan?
Iya.
Yeah. Jadi, insert aja comments-nya dari kedua referensi tersebut, bedanya dengan penelitian ini adalah pada teori yang digunakan. Mereka menggunakan makai, saya menggunakan ini gitu loh. You know?
Yes, ma'am.
Terus, okay, we go to chapter 3 ya. Chapter 3-mu, okay. Here, if you don't use participants or subjects, yeah, so you don't have to put research setting and subjects, but data and source of data, because this is a document research, yeah. So you don't involve people directly. Kamu tidak langsung melibatkan orang kan di sini kan? Ya, datamu dalam bentuk apa? What are your data? Datamu dalam bentuk apa?
Dalam bentuk lembar instrumen saja, mem.
Bapak.
Jawabnya instrumen.
Datamu apa? Teks atau apa?
Oh, Mbak Yu. Ha?
Dalam bentuk teks, mem.
A text? Are you sure?
The whole text? Is it the whole text?
Text apa? Sorry, ma'am.
Data kamu, teks katanya. Teks apa, Mbak? Saya udah bengok, ya, udah teriak-teriak di rumah loh. Teks apa?
Teks.
Teks dalam bentuk tabel, mem.
No.
Iya, Mbak. Teks sama tabel masa sama? Hah? Tabel, teks ya, teks. Iya, toh.
21 biji itu loh, Napria. Apa itu namanya? Ya.
Gemes toh pembimbingnya.
Yang 21 biji itu apa?
Oh, yang 21 itu mem lirik, teks liriknya mem. Nanti teks liriknya itu nanti saya bikinkan tabelnya masing-masing.
Datanya berarti wujudnya apa?
Dalam bentuk dokumen gitu.
Dokumen.
Aduh. Ya.
Dan itu banyak, sebutkan apa? Itu apa?
Maaf, mem, apa, mem?
Iya, saya tanya kamu, data kamu itu apa? Ini udah bahasa Indonesia, Mbak, nanti saya bahasa Jawa loh, lama-lama ya. Umat, ya. Patah, ketawa tuh.
Ya, itu bisa bahasa Jawa kali ya?
Oh ya, bisa bahasa Jawa? Enggak, itu takut.
Oke, Nafria, datamu bentuknya apa? Teks itu apa? Lagu, lirik lagu. Kau kok bingung sih? Aduh, kau meneliti apa?
Nah, itu.
What do you want to do?
Itu betul kata Bapak. Apa kamu mau meneliti apa katanya?
Meneliti idiomatic expression yang berada yang ada di dalam lirik lagu. Ya,
itu data kamu, ngerti nggak kamu? Itu data kamu, idiomatic expressions dalam lirik lagu. Atau datanya adalah lirik lagu yang mengandung idiomatic expression. Sumber datanya apa sekarang?
Sumber datanya
gini. Tadi data, lirik lagu yang mengandung idiomatic expressions. Ya, the song lyrics having idiomatic expressions itu data. Sumber datanya apa? Sumbernya
dari genius.com website, mem.
Dari website. Website itu luas banyak. Website yang mana?
Judul tempatnya itu genius.com, mem.
Ya, dari situ apakah hanya ada satu saja?
Iya.
Isinya hanya satu saja?
Banyak, mem. Karena bentuk website.
Apa sebutkan yang tepatnya? Yang kau ambil dari situ itu apa?
Lirik-lirik lagu dari 21 tadi, mem.
lirik lagu kan tadi sudah data, sumber datanya lagu, lagu itu punya lirik, lirik yang mengandung idiomatic expression yang kamu jadikan data. Ngerti nggak bedanya source of data and data? Tahu? Sumber datanya adalah lagu atau soundtrack dalam film apa, Aladdin?
Oh ya,
film market movie. Yang komplit, ngerti nggak? Itu sumber datanya. Soundtracks ya, in the movies, work it. Itu sumber data. The data, the lyrics, ya, having idiomatic expressions found on the soundtracks of work it. Begitu, Mbak, ya. Itu dirubah ya, 3.2-nya data and source of data. Karena tidak ada orang yang dilibatkan di sini. So there will be no setting and... Kan nggak enak dibaca setting is in my place, in my bedroom, in my study.
Ya, tadi,
ya, tadi yang rumah, sok begitu. Diceritakan kepada orang lain kan ya. Sambil rebahan gitu ya. Generasi rebahan, oke? Okay? And then we go to the... A data collection topics or procedures and data analysis procedures. It's so ajaib for me. Yeah. It's so you only put two steps on each of the processes here. Yeah. Step-nya cuma dua. Okay, could you explain to me what are you going to do on how to collect your data? 3, 4.
Researcher explore data on the genius.com website, and B, researcher collect data by copying one by one into a Word document and save with file name S1 until S26, ma'am. S21.
Ah, ini 26. Ya. Ya, yeah. Yeah, nanti di data and source of data you retell ya yeah, that you only take 26 songs because the other songs do not have lyrics. Kan? Kenapa yang diambil 21 saja, 4 lagu lagi kan tidak ada liriknya. Itu ditaruh di data and source of data tadi ya, source of data. Lalu di sini ya tidak 26, yang 4 kan sudah dibuang istilahnya. Kamu ya sebut aja S21 ya sampai 21. Lalu from A here, researcher explores data on the genius. What are you exploring that, or what do you explore?
Maksud saya itu kayak kayak mencari gitu loh, mem.
Nah, sih gue boleh apa yang kamu cari apa?
Lirik lagu. Lirik-lirik dari.
Saya mencari kekasih hati saya yang hilang. Ya tulislah kok lengkap-lengkap. Yeah. Biar tahu pembaca itu apa yang kau cari, ya, oke? Okay. Okay. Nah, sudah ketemu, what next? What's next?
Jadi kalau sudah dicari lirik lagunya itu, nanti saya simpan lagi, saya kumpulkan lagi, saya simpan di dokumen Word gitu, mem.
Sudah, itu sudah.
Setelah itu kalau sudah gitu saya kasih satu lagu itu satu lirik itu satu file gitu, terus ada penulisnya, terus penyanyinya dengan judul lagunya.
Oke, terus sudah,
terus saya kalau sudah kayak gitu nanti saya analisis lagi, mem, baru saya baca
analisis. Belum analisis, ini ngumpulin masih. Sudah dapat datanya, sudah ya. Datanya apa, datamu tadi apa, tadi lirik. Sudah dijelaskan data kamu apa tadi,
lirik dari soundtrack Work It Movie, ma'am.
Yang syaratnya yang
ya, mem, maaf, mem,
syaratnya apa, lirik dari soundtrack yang
lirik dari soundtrack
semua lirik.
Iya, semua lirik.
Yang jadi data kamu semua lirik?
Iya, semua lirik dari soundtrack.
Kamu mau teliti apa?
Idiomatic expression, mem.
Nah, kalau nggak ada idiomatic expression-nya, kamu taruh juga nggak?
Harusnya ada, mem. tapi nggak ada. Nah,
harusnya kayak terserah kamu, mau kamu taruh atau enggak. Nah, penelitianmu apa ya? Sesuaikan di situ. Berarti kan belum selesai prosesnya, Mbak. Ya, masih mengidentifikasi lirik yang mengandung.
Idiomatic expression. Nah,
sudah ketemu lirik yang mengandung idiomatic expressions, terus kamu apakan?
Terus saya
analisis.
Iya, saya klasifikasikan lagi sesuai dengan kalau sudah saya temukan gitu mem idiomatic expressionnya, terus saya klasifikasikan.
Sebelum diklasifikasikan, saya sarankan diberi codingnya, coding dulu supaya enak, karena dalam table kamu saya lihat ada baris ya, line toh, L itu line kan, baris ya. Keberapa kamu temukan, nah itu dikasih coding gitu loh Mbak. Ya. Jadi baris ketiga pada judul ini ya mengandung idiomatic expression, itu dikumpulin semua dulu dari 21 lagu tersebut, kamu dapat berapa lirik, itu datanya, data collection-nya, ngerti nggak?
Ya, ma'am.
Paham nggak?
Ya, paham.
Nah, di revisi ya step-nya, tidak cuma dua. Kamu sebut banyak loh tadi.
Ya, ma'am.
Nah, termasuk membaca, ya, mengidentifikasi, memberi coding. Oke, okay, and then your data analysis procedures. Okay, could you explain to me?
Oh, excuse me, ma'am. What, ma'am? Teknik.
Data analisismu bagaimana, Mbak?
Right. Ya, sesuai
dengan... Iya.
Researcher identifies and underlines sentences that have the characteristic of idiomatic expression.
Ini data analysis or data collection?
Data analysis, ma'am.
Are you sure? Cuma mengidentifikasi dan menggarisbawahi. Nah, ini harusnya belong to data collection procedures. Kalau sudah analisis, itu sudah mulai classifying.
Ya, ya, classifying, ma'am.
Click on.
On.
How will you do the classification?
Based on Palmer theory, ma'am.
Tulis begitu, number one or A, ya. Classifying the idiomatic expressions found on the lyrics yang konflik teroritnya into the types based on Palmer's theory. Ya. Sudah diklasifikasikan, and then?
Kalau sudah diklasifikasikan, nanti...
Kamu sudah kan selesai, padahal ada lagi. Kalau your research problem. How will you answer your research problem? Ada tiga dong?
Ya.
Apa saja tadi?
Tipe, dominan, dan meaning, ma'am.
Terus gimana ini kalau sudah diklasifikasikan?
Terus nanti saya meaning-nya, ma'am. Kontekstual ininya kalau sudah saya temukan idiomatic expression-nya, terus saya klasifikasikan berdasarkan tipe-tipenya tadi, berdasarkan teori Palmer, and then I have to find the meaning, ma'am. Terus kalau sudah, nanti saya hitung lagi secara apa sih yang dominan dari setiap
ya mbak jangan ya. Jawab saya tulis sendiri itu loh
ya mem,
ngerti nggak? Kamu cuma dua tulisanmu tuh, yang satu aja salah taruh, yang atas itu taruh di data collection, yang B step pertama, step kedua kamu cari maknanya kan, analyzing the meaning, step ketiga terus kamu taruh di table tabel ya. Tuh terus kamu cari dominant type, terus kamu habis itu
didiskusikan dan conclusion, ma'am.
Kan terus habis diskusikan
conclusion, ma'am.
Lima langkah lagi yang tidak tertulis.
Ya.
It is not completed yet.
Yes, ma'am. That's my fault. I'm sorry.
So I will not care about the transferability and then dependability. I don't care about this. Oh, okay, thank you, Bu Maida.
Thank you very much, Bu Erma, for your review. Now, Pak Tampung, do you have any suggestions or any feedback for Novia? Please, Bapak. You are still muted. Maybe you can. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Ibu Irma. So the comment and the question so already comprehensive. Yeah. Nafria, have you make a note already?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What is important? You have to put more. Firstly, you have to put the academic reasons on the background. Why are you interested in this research? Okay.
Yes, sir.
And then you have to put the introductory paragraph as well in every paragraph. Got it?
Yes.
And then you have to put also, what is it? The theory of contextual meaning, you know? Contextual meaning. Contextual meaning is something that related to the context the songs are created or the film. Okay?
Yes, sir.
But we have to put the theory. And then many things already mentioned by Ibu Irma. Also the Palmer's theory, you have to provide about idiomatic, okay?
Yes,
many things you have to improve, like the source of data and the data needed, yeah? And the technique of data collection and technique of data analysis. Right? One important thing that you have to think about, are you dealing with translation or not?
No, ma'am. And no, sir.
No. Okay, so it is not strongly related to the translation. If you would like to find the contextual meaning, you don't have to do something like translation. However, it is related to the interpretation or something like that. And you have to find out the background, the contextual, the background of the movie and also the song. The movie, what is the background of the movie? Like, when was the movie created, or when was the song created? Okay. So when the movie created in the special situation or condition of the people or the community, and then that is the contextual you have to relate. Yeah. Kalau lagu-lagu apa film perang ya lagu-lagunya lagu-lagu heroik ya apalagi ya. Ya itulah kontekstualnya ya. Ini filmnya film apa ini kira-kira?
Drama musikal.
Hah?
A dance musikal drama.
Dance ya drama. Oke. Okay. You have to know when was that musical dance drama created or composed, ya? Yeah? So that must be based on the background or the contextual or the situation when that drama is created or composed, right? And then related to the song and the idiomatic expression. So idiomatic expression, you cannot translate it word by word because it has different meaning, yeah?
Yes.
And it is also related to, what do you call that? Tradition and culture, maybe. Okay. That's all my comment, Ibu
Maida.
Pak? Ini Bu Mida?
Ya, Pak.
Maida.
Alright, thank you so much, Pak Kampung, for your review. So, this is my last comment for you, Navria, as your advisor one. I'm telling you that I smacked my phone on the floor twice this morning because of you. Because I'm very gemes, you know. I really know you. I know you. I have known you since 2018, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. 2018, and I do know that you cannot catch the meaning or cannot catch the explanation just in one shot. You need 3 or 4 times to understand what people are saying, right? And I know that's your characteristic. So I ask you to ask the record, this record of Zoom, to Kawahyu, and you listen carefully all of the things stated by the review. And also that side. That is? Yeah. So the last thing that I want to discuss with you is related to your technique, data collection and data analysis. I still remember that I was discussing this with you, that I asked you to put everything that you did on, or everything that you will do on the list. Yeah. So I'm talking about the coding also, but you didn't put any coding there. But that's okay. You still have time to revise everything based on Ibu Erna's fit. Okay? Yeah. So got it? Yeah, if you have questions, you can ask Ibu Erna or you can ask me and Pak Amin. Yeah. You will have 2 weeks to revise all of the things. Okay? Go to Ibu Erma first and finish everything with her. Yeah. Listen to the recording. Listen to the recording and revise everything based on it. Yeah. So congratulations. You have finished your thesis proposal seminar. This is new stuff for you, but you still have more step ahead. Okay? You still have the revision. Okay, Napriya. So Ibu Erma and Pak Tampung, thank you very much for coming. I think this is the end of Navria's thesis proposal seminar. Thank you very much for your feedbacks, Bapak dan Ibu. And we'll give Navria 2 weeks to revise. Okay? Ibu Erma,
yeah.
Can you agree with that? Okay.
It is a very heavy raining here, so I couldn't catch your word. It's raining heavily. In my place.
Okay, it's okay, Ibu. So I think this is the end of today's seminar.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Ibu Erma. Thank you very much, Pak Tampu, and thank you very much, everyone. We'll be signing out. See you again later.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Tampu izin keluar.
Goodbye, Ibu. Goodbye, Bapak. Everyone. Goodbye. Good morning.
Thank you, Ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you, Pak. Terima kasih, Ma'am.
Thank you.
Awas yes. Ya, kamu nggak revisi sesuai yang ini. Kamu tuh paling susah kalau hanya dikasih satu kali saja penjelasan. Sampai tulis biasanya. Awas kalau masih keliru lagi. Benar-benar, Navria. Jadi fokus. Kamu kalau ditanya itu harus fokus tujuanmu apa. Terus lagi apa yang kamu tulis itu tulis semua.
Ya.
Karena paling penting itu Pak ya, untuk data collection, procedure dan analisis itu harus jelas apapun yang kamu tulis. Harus apapun yang kamu lakukan harus kamu tulis. Yang kamu tulis juga jangan general, misalnya kamu mencari lirik lagu apa dari soundtrack movie what it ditulis. Jadi biar tidak ada pertanyaan lagi. Tadi terlalu general saja. Ya.
Oke, okay, Mas.
Ya, ingat data analysis sampai conclusion.
Oke, okay. Okay, ya,
yeah. Oke. Okay. Semangat, selamat mengerjakan revisi.
Ya, yeah. Terima kasih.
Sama Bapak, terima kasih Pak ya.
Terima kasih.
Baik Pak, goodbye.
Terima kasih kawan-kawan.
Semangat Pria.
Thank you.